I was online just basically going through the internet to see if I could find any more additional information involving Anthony Farrell since the last update that I did about him. And I stumbled upon this article right here that you see on your screen. Now, this is just a screenshot of the first part of the article. And this is exactly why I call lamestream media by its proper name. So, as you can see, on this part, it says brewery gunman accused of punching a woman and having a gun crime in the 90s. And dated, and I made sure to underline the date, February 28th, 2020. They made sure to throw that out there, like, almost immediately after the shooting occurred. Now, luckily, this particular story did not pick up that much steam. Otherwise, I probably would have caught it. But I didn't, and I don't think anyone else did either. Because, you know, I think it probably got lost somewhere. But this just shows you how lamestream media actually operates right here. They had to make sure to make this person out to be as the biggest bad guy as they possibly could before they sent out the story about him having or facing racial tension or being racially profiled, racially harassed, however you want to put it, on the job. Which segues into this one, and I hope y'all can see it on your screen. Now, look at the date for this one. Posted March 3rd, 2020, but updated March 4th, 2020. Now, this is the one we all heard right here. Because they wanted to know a reason as to why, but they wanted to lead with something like what happened first, as if that would happen in the 90s, allegedly, is what caused what happened a couple weeks ago at his job. There was no comparison whatsoever. This right here, this story right here on your screen, is more likely to be the reason as to why he did what he did. But lamestream media had to lead with that other story or go out with that one. But as you can see, it didn't really pick up that much steam, because I'm going to be honest, before like a couple days ago, I didn't even know that first story existed. But when I had made my video, I automatically just assumed that it had to be something that triggered this guy to go off the way that he did. And nowhere in my mind would I have believed that the triggering point would have been what happened with the first story you saw on your screen. Most likely this one would be the one. But lamestream media had to make this man be as big of a boogeyman as possible. But in my honest opinion, they failed with that first story. But you see how quick they put it out there. But it got quickly buried as well. And this is the one that pretty much rose to the occasion. But they're going to try to bury this one as well. I wouldn't be surprised if they try to bury this one and then try to push the one that you saw up on your screen before this one. But that's just another notch on the belt as to why I call lamestream media by its proper name. It's a good thing that I went and saw this. And I said, let me go ahead and click this and screenshot this and put these two article pieces side by side and let my followers on Twitter see what this is all about. And I said, I'll probably do a video about it so my subscribers who aren't on Twitter can see what it is as well. But y'all let me know what y'all think about this down in the comments. Like, share, subscribe. Make sure you follow me on Twitter if you haven't done so already. If you can, have your notifications turned on. And one more thing. If you notice, the authors of both articles are two different people. Well, actually three different people, because two of them wrote the first one and someone else wrote the second one. And they're coming from two different sources. I think the first one was from the Associated Press, if I'm not mistaken. And I want to say this one may have been USA Today or one of those other particular news sites.